हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, योर टॉपिक फॉर टुडे इज रिकॉर्ड ऑफ राइट्स। सो रिकॉर्ड ऑफ राइट्स, मेंटेनेंस ऑफ मैप्स एंड रिकॉर्ड्स, एनुअल रजिस्ट्रेशन, सेक्शन 113 टू सेक्शन 137। अंडर दीज सेक्शंस दीज थिंग्स आर कवर्ड: रिकॉर्ड ऑफ राइट्स, मेंटेनेंस ऑफ मैप्स एंड रिकॉर्ड्स एंड एनुअल रजिस्ट्रेशन। Section 116 is talking about the procedure whenever an unclaimed land is used for any common purpose. If there is no claim made to such kind of a land as mentioned in section 115, or if such land is decided to be a property of state but the inhabitants of the adjoining village or village prove that they have theretofore enjoyed the use of such land for a pastoral or for other agriculture purposes, then the land record officer will assign to such village or village to such land as he may consider requisite for such purpose and shall mark off the remainder as and declare it to be a property of the state. Then section 117, procedure when limited right over such land is established. So if a claim to the exercise of enjoyment of any right that is not amounting to right of exclusive possession into or over any land comprised in the proclamation issued under section 115 is established, then the land record officer may assign to the claimant as his property a defined portion of such land or with the sanction of the state government, otherwise compensate the claimant in accordance with the provision of the Rajasthan Land Acquisition Act 1953, and such assignment or compensation shall be held extinguish all claims on account of such exercise or enjoyment. Now section 118, determination and record of khudkash land. So all the land record officers shall ascertain and determine the extent of all land as khudkash and shall record the same as such. Then section 119 talks about the determination of the abadi of a village. So the record officer shall, in the case of every inhabited village, ascertain and determine the area that is to be reserved for the residence of the inhabitants thereof or for purposes ancillary thereto, and such area shall be deemed to be abadi of such village. Now section 120 talks about the register of villages. So the land record officer has to prepare in a prescribed form list of all the villages in the area, and under the survey and under the record operations or under record operations showing therein in the prescribed manner, that is the area liable to fill cultivation, the area having precarious cultivation, the revenue or rent assessed therein, and the person through whom it is payable, and the area of which the revenue or rent has either wholly or in part been released, remitted, assigned or compounded, specifying the authority therefore and the conditions thereof. Now section 121 is talking about the particulars to be stated in the Khatani. So this section is talking about what all particulars should be mentioned, specified as to each tenant, and these are like the nature and class of his tenure, the amount of premium, the date of kitab parcha, the kharsa number of each field, that is the annual rent payable by him, by other any other conditions for the tenure, whether in case of a person other than a khatida tenant, then the number of years during which he has held the land then in his possession, and such other particulars as may from time to time be prescribed. Then the registrar shall also specify the estate holders, now section 122, attestation of entries. So all undisputed entries in the record of right shall be attested by the parties interested. Section 124, procedure, it talks about the procedure when rent or revenue is payable is disputed. So if in case of a dispute is there regarding the rent or the revenue payable, then the land record officer will decide on such kind of a dispute. Then section 126, existing records to be acted upon. So until a new map and field book is not prepared under section 112, or until a new record of rights is not framed under section 114, the existing ones will be the concerned ones. Then section 127, proceeding that is pending upon close of survey and record operations. So when the survey and record operations, or the record operations as the case may be, are closed by notification under section 106 or section 107, then all applications and proceedings that are pending before the additional land records officer shall, if such officer has not been appointed, permanently be transferred to the collector. Now section 128, boundary disputes. So all disputes that are concerning boundaries shall be decided by land record officer. And then section 129, obligation of holders as to these boundary marks. So this is talking about the obligations. So all holders of villages, estates or fields shall be bound to maintain and keep in repair and their own cost the permanent boundary marks lawfully erected thereon, and the land record officer may at any time order such holders to erect proper boundary marks on such villages, estates or fields, to repair or renew in such form and material as he may prescribe all boundaries marked lawfully erected thereon. Second, if such order is not compiled within 30 days from the communication, then such officer shall cause such boundary marks as to be erected, repaired or renewed, and shall recover the charges incurred from the holders concerned in such proportions as he thinks fit. And third, if in case of boundary or fields where there is no dispute as to such boundaries, action under subsections 1 or and 2 may be taken by the tehsildar upon an application made to him or otherwise. Then section 130, penalty for injury to or removal of marks. So the land record officers may order any person found to have willfully erased, removed or damaged a boundary or survey mark to pay such sum, not exceeding tiny rupees, for each mark so erased, removed or damaged. Then section 131, maintenance of map and field book. So these maps and field books should be maintained. Then section 132, annual registration. So the land record officer shall maintain the record of rights, and for that purpose it shall annually or at such longer intervals as the state government may prescribe, cause to be prepared a set or an amendment set as the case may be of the registers enumerated in section 114, and the registers so prepared shall be called the annual register. So the land record officer shall cause to be recording the annual registers in the prescribed manner, and all the changes that take place and any transaction that may affect any of the rights or interested should be reported. Then section 113 is talking about a report of succession and transfer of possession. So every person who is obtaining possession by succession or by transfer or otherwise of any kind of property or other right or interest in any land or the profit thereof, which is required by this act or any rules made thereunder, to be recorded in annual registration, they shall bring the fact to the notice of the village patwari, and it should report to the tehsildar of the tehsil in which such land is situated, either director to the village patwari or land record inspector, within 3 months from the date of which he obtains such possession. So if such person is a minor or otherwise disqualified, then the guardian or other person who has charge of such person's property shall make such report. Section 134, fine for neglect to report. So any person neglecting to make the report required by section 133 shall be liable to be a fine not exceeding rupees 10. Now section 135, procedure on report. So the tehsildar, on receiving such report or upon the act coming otherwise to his knowledge, shall make such inquiry as appears necessary, and in undisputed cases, if the succession or transfer or other acquisition appears to have taken place, and shall record the same in annual registrations. So if succession or transfer of other acquisition is disputed, then the tehsildar shall, if the completed under this act or any other law for a time being in force, decide such dispute according to law, and if not so competent, refer the dispute to any other officer so competent for decision. Then section 136, correction of errors. So the land record officer may at any time correct or cause to be corrected in the prescribed manner any clerical errors and any errors which the parties interested admit to have been made in the record of rights or register, or which a revenue officer may notice during the course of his inspection in any register, provided that when any error is noticed by the revenue officer in any record of rights during the course of his inspection, no error shall be corrected unless a notice to show cause has been given to the parties. Then section 137, succession of estates. So notwithstanding anything contained in this act, succession to and transfer of an estate shall be governed and regulated by, determined in accordance with the law, usage or practice of the local area in which such estate lies, and such law, usage or practice shall notwithstanding the provisions of section 263 continue in force for the purpose of assent. That's all. Thank you.